Okay, this last video in this free series of anti-bullying and self-protection for kids video is more so geared towards middle school kids or high school kids. And guys, I really want you to look at the first two videos in this series on my channel here and have a look at why I'm doing what I'm doing and understand a little bit more about the mindset or what's sort of necessary in terms of looking at anti-bullying. Now, the reason I'm doing this video is because I get a lot of messages from kids and I don't reply. You know, a lot of the time I've seen them very late. I get messages from hundreds and hundreds of people. We've got schools and students, groups, training groups in 40 countries now. So, you know, the amount of messages a day I get alone, let me see on my phone here, I think it's around 48,000, look at that, 48,000 unread messages on my my email thing on my phone alone. That's not including Facebook or YouTube or Twitter or any of that other sort of crap. Basically, I'm very, very busy and I'd like you to understand and appreciate that. So I'm going to explain to you now why I don't reply a lot of those things, because I used to. I said to one or two people, you know, this is something you've got to consider, and basically, you know, it's very dangerous. So you know, I get these messages and most of the time it'll be, hey man, I've got a fight tomorrow, what do I do? Or, hey man, this guy's picking on me, I wanna mess him up, what should I do, how should I go about it? Look, firstly, I'm not your parent, I'm not even your teacher, your school teacher and or your martial arts teacher, and I'm in no position legally nor morally to give you advice on any of that. I don't know the situation, I don't know who you are, and I don't know why you'd ask someone on the internet that you don't even know. That's not safe, and it's not good practice. So I just want to say that first, okay? Now, the other thing is, you cannot watch a video, especially just one video, or have some sort of advice from some guy and think, right, now I can take on the world. Right, now I can take on this guy, I can mess him up, I can do whatever. In my last video, in the last video of this free series just here, I said that martial arts and combatives is just like walking around with a loaded gun. It's, you know, there's huge responsibility with it. It can easily get you in a lot of trouble, and it can be more dangerous to you if you don't know how to use it efficiently, effectively, and in a realistic way. That means, you know, when, where, how, why. All these things that you've really got to know and understand and be capable, as in have that proper skill, if and when necessary to use it. I'm not talking about the gun anymore, I'm talking about martial arts and or combatives. Combatives is something that I mainly teach, martial arts is something I do as a hobby. So I'm trying to help you guys understand why I put these videos up on YouTube. These videos that I put up on YouTube, unless it says tutorial or how to or whatever, is usually just a demonstration of what I'm doing, okay? Like I said, we have students throughout the world in so many countries, in so many languages, from different races and religions and whatever, and that's great. I'm trying to make this available to as many people as possible. Unfortunately, in recent times, especially in the last few years, a lot of people message me and say, hey man, what should I do? Hey, how come you didn't message me back? Hey, this, that, the other. I go, hold on, you know, I don't know you, for one, like I said, and two, you shouldn't be doing this. You shouldn't be approaching someone online, okay? So, please, when you're watching my videos, make sure that you understand that most of them are 3, maybe 5 minutes. Some are a little bit longer, but mostly 3 to 5 minutes. Some a lot shorter, yes. They are a small clip out of a whole day or 2 days or a weekend or a week of training with me that is one little part of what we did. So what I might have said before and after is very, very relevant, but not in that video. So it might just be, like I said, demonstrating for advertising purposes for people to come join us. You know, that's it really, okay? So with bullying, what I want you to understand is that it's so important that you avoid and prevent things from happening to you. It's so stupid for people to try and be responsive or be reactive. If you allow something to happen to you, then you've let it happen to you. Whatever situation you get yourself in, you've got yourself in. You see, so if someone's picking on me and picking on me and saying something, and then they push me, and then they grab me, and then they punch me, and then they push me downstairs, I've let them do that. Okay, I've let them push me that far. So when they first approach me and they say, hey, I don't like that hat, that thing you're wearing on your head. Why? Because you haven't got one? You know, like being able to throw something back at them, be confident, be, you know, have that sort of confidence to be able to say, listen, I don't care what you think, your opinion is nothing to me, and I'm doing my thing anyway. I'm doing what I do. You can do what you do. How about you stay there and have fun with your friends or whatever? At least be able to throw it back at them, okay? So if not, you're going to show that you're willing to take whatever they're dishing out, okay? So people will always test you. People will always push you and see how far they can push you and see what you're willing to take, and they will keep pushing you. A lot of the time, they'll keep pushing and pushing and pushing. It might start, like I said, with name calling. It might start with physically pushing you. It might start with grabbing your shirt or whatever. If you have to get physical, then only do what's necessary. If you just have to push away and scream at them and say, stay away from me, act a little bit crazy. But that doesn't mean picking up things and throwing things at them or hurting them physically. That just means, don't come near me. I'm not willing to take your shit. Okay? As simple as that. Now, that is obviously a lot more positive than getting physically involved with that person, because like I said in the other video, you never come out unharmed. If you go into a fight, it's a fight. You're going to get punched in the head at the very least. Okay? So if you're willing to accept that, fine. But if you're willing to accept that and you still want to go through with it, you're a bit of an idiot. Okay? So try and use your head. All right? Try and avoid and prevent any of these things from happening. And like I said, if you're going to study martial arts, self-defense, or whatever, make sure it's relevant. Make sure it's realistic. Don't just listen to what people are telling you. A lot of martial arts masters will tell you things to sell their art, to sell their thing. I'm not dissing or disrespecting any martial arts styles or masters. People are in it for business these days. But there's some free advice for you. I've been doing this my whole life. I've got multiple black belts and certificates of this, that, and the other. I've traveled throughout Asia the last 10 years. I live in Japan. I've got ranks in jujitsu and swordsmanship and all these other things. And I'm friends with some of the great top masters here in Japan. But what I can tell you is that at the end of the day, they're doing it for a business. Okay? They don't do it out of the kindness of their heart. They're doing it to feed their family a lot of the time too. So what they do might suit them, but you've got to make sure what you do suits you and your situation. So for me, as I was dealing with violence on a very, very consistent and regular basis as a professional, I need something that works, and that's why I do what I do. Okay, because what I do is simple and effective, and it keeps me out of trouble and it keeps me safe. If you want to know more, if you're of age, if you're an adult, then you can get online. And you can check out a free online learning. If not, you need your parents' permission, and they'll need to make an account. But I recommend, even more so than any of that, if you're not near a raw combat school or group, or training group, then you should be going to something like boxing or Muay Thai. You know, kids always ask me, what's the best martial art to learn? And they'll say, I've heard ninjutsu is great, or this is great. Look, everything's great, right? But if you want to learn how to fight, learn how to fight. Okay, that's the thing. Like, I did boxing and kickboxing as a kid. I did taekwondo, I did judo, I did all sorts of stuff. But one of the best things I learned is how to take a punch and give one back. Because most martial arts, people in martial arts don't know how to take a punch. They go, what if this punch comes? What if that punch comes? What? How about you give it to me and we'll see. You know, that's always my answer now. That's not what I'm saying you should do. But what I'm saying is boxing and kickboxing, at the very least, teaches you offense. Okay, yeah, you learn defense as well. But you learn how to throw a punch most of the time before you learn how to take a punch, and you will learn how to take a punch. Okay, so I teach Muay Thai at this gym here at War Combat Japan, and I've been doing Muay Thai. I started Muay Thai in about 98, okay, as my first introduction to Muay Thai, sort of officially. I thought, wow, this is great, because I'd done a little bit of boxing before and I learned how to take a hit and I wasn't scared of that. But Muay Thai, you learn, you know, punches and elbows and knees and kicks and everything. It's great. Like I said, but the thing that you're going to need above all of this, not just learning how to fight and learning how to take a punch, if that's what you want to do, is self-discipline. Like I said, having any of these skills, I'll say it again, is like walking around with a loaded gun or any type of weapon. It can get you into trouble very easily if you don't use it, you know, as a last resort, if and when necessary. And, you know, if you don't know how to use it in a realistic way, then it can be more dangerous to you than the other person, or the adversary, the threat, the opponent, whatever, okay, the bad guy. So I want you to think about those things, please. Now, remember, a lot of my videos, like I said in the other one, aren't for kids. A lot of my videos are simple demonstrations or parts of a day of training with me, like a couple of minutes here or there, but that's not a lesson. So if you're going to learn something, please go and learn something. I highly recommend you take up boxing or Muay Thai, like I said, because it's very, very simple. It teaches you to move, it teaches you how to take a punch, it makes you toughen up, makes you strong, and I think, personally, I just think what's simple is most effective. So if you can't get to a raw combat school or gym or training group, get into a Muay Thai class and keep it simple, keep it raw, as we say, and always stay safe. Thank you for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Thank you.